Dit is het verhaal van een boeddhistische monnik en van een boeddhistische non. En van hun niet aflatende strijd om hun angst te overstijgen.
My name is Nong Sangdun. I'm a Tibetan nun.
Yes, my name is Bagdo. I'm a Tibetan Buddhist monk. I don't know what happened to Tibet. I'm very young. Nobody gave me information what exactly Tibetan culture, what exactly Tibetan history. My fathers, my mother, they know everything. But he don't teach me anything, he's scared. I have three sisters, one brothers. I remember I'm very young age. I go sometime to the capital Lhasa. I'm begging for food at the Chinese restaurant. Somebody go my place. They said you must go back home. Then I go to my family house. And I saw my sister dead body. She's 3-4 years old. And I'm very sad. My mother, she's much cry. My father cry. My old sister, she's cry. And I'm very surprised my sister dead. What happened? What is meaning my sister dead? He's dead, starvation. It's no food. How much my family suffer? How much I see this my village? It's not only my village. It's not only my families. It's all Tibet.
When I was young, I believed the Dalai Lama because my parents told me the Dalai Lama is our leader. They told me it's when Chinese invade Tibet, lots of Tibetan people died of starvation. And they destroyed thousands of ancient monasteries.
This is the first time in thousands of years that the Tibetan peasants are able to grow crops for themselves.
I'm going to Chinese school. They teach re-education.
The oppression and exploitation which the Tibetan peasants suffered for centuries have now been relegated to the past.
They said Tibetan Buddhism is like poison. This is brainwashing people mind. So I trust in the communist system. I like communist system. Our family house, they hang in Mao Zedong picture. Liberate Tibetan people.
In truth, springtime has come to Tibet.
So my parents says, before I was born, my biggest brother, when he 13 years old, Chinese army shoot him to die on the street. My parents told us lots of, so I couldn't to listen, it's too sad. Actually, my parents secretly do something for my country. They make the Tibetan flag at home and they secretly put down the flag on the street.
I see the Chinese very rich, the communists and the Chairman Mao, he need Tibet keep secret. They don't show around the world.
Meer dan 10 miljoen Chinezen zijn omgekomen tijdens de culturele revolutie van Mao Zedong. In 1976 sterft voorzitter Mao.
And they need a bit change in the Chinese politics system. They open business, they open border. In 1983, the Chinese give a little bit religious freedom in Tibet. I said, I like stay here, but I'm very hungry. I need food and a better life. I like go monastery, I told my father, but I need permission. Chinese police said, you don't forget Mao Zedong. You don't forget the communist system. It's most important. After 1 year, they gave me permission. After I go monasteries, I'm very happy because I have good food, also good teacher. I must change my life. Every day I wake up in the morning, 3 o'clock, start some reading the Buddhist text.
I'm 12 years old and became a nun. Then my parents were very, very happy. They sent me to the Guru Nunnery.
We have rebuilt the monastery because the Chinese destroyed monastery. And then slowly, slowly, the Western tourists come to Tibet. We are very surprised, these tourists. We think these people come in another world. We don't know American, we don't know Europe. These people, they see what happened to Tibet. They have democracy country. They have respect to human right. But they give food, they give clothes, they give money, these tourists.
I said, foreigner. Lots of Tibetan children, they called, hello, Dalai Lama teacher, hello, Dalai Lama teacher. Everybody is like that. So they give us Dalai Lama teacher, then we're happy. This is my first words I learned, hello, and the Dalai Lama teacher.
Wie in Tibet een foto van de Dalai Lama in zijn bezit heeft, riskeert een gevangenisstraf.
Because I'm going to Chinese school, I think maybe Tibetan leaders, Chami Mao, not Dalai Lama. Then in 1987, two American tourists gave me Dalai Lama picture. These two American tourists, the woman, she speaking Tibetan language, she gave me book, Dalai Lama book, My Land, My People. This book I read. I'm very, very shocked that this is what they're doing, this Chinese.
Tibetanen die weigeren hun geloof af te zweren worden gekruisigd, levend begraven, aan stukken gesneden of publiek onthoofd. En na de collectivisering van de Tibetaanse boerderijen sterven honderdduizenden de hongerdood.
I read this book.
In 1960 concludeert een internationale commissie van juristen dat er in Tibet een volkenmoord aan de gang is.
Now, I got very good information. I got very good knowledge. This book opened my eye and opened my heart. I understand exactly what happened to my sister. I'm very angry. I understand very clear. This book making me change. And I understand I need to fight for freedom. This book make me change my life.
And the Chinese employee often come our nunnery and they teach us their politics. This was always on the TV and the radio. The Chinese government go to Tibet, and also Tibet belong to the China. Some nun, they speak out, we don't believe that, we don't want to listen to you. Then they take those to the jail.
I saw many countries, the church, Hindu temple, they're no soldiers, no police. They do what they like, free. That's religious freedom. I gave this book to the monk. I said, this is our country. Now we have tramps fight for free Tibet. And then even some monks will write this poster for free Tibet. Long live Dalai Lama, Chinese get out Tibet now. Then even I hang it everywhere. And the Chinese police office, all areas are hanging this poster. Also hanging Tibetan flag. I'm scared and also very excited. Maybe someone watch me. After morning, the Chinese police, they know what I'm doing, but they don't know for me. This news come to Tibet, some secret news. Some monks, they know, but they don't say me anything, scared. Sometimes they don't trust each other. But the monks also, they are very excited. Dalai Lama, he spoke in America Congress.
The future Tibet must be zone of peace. In the past, Tibet acted as a buffer state. So since Chinese invasion, since the Chinese used to put a lot of Chinese stationed a lot of Chinese soldier army in Tibet, then they said their situation on that continent completely changed. So in future, Tibet is created as a demilitarized a zone of peace and can be a tremendous benefit for all those states there.
And then two monasteries, very close Lhasa. These two monasteries also strong for free Tibet. They have peace for demonstration. The Chinese, they're using weapon. They're killing. They tortured, they beat, they took in prison. But we like support this monastery, what they're doing. But maybe I'm going to protest. But if I go prison, I never give any people a name. And the next day, 1,000 soldiers come in my monastery. Monastery 200 monk. They said, you don't support. This protest is very terrible. This disturbing Tibet. They bring a big weapon and tank and special air force and the military and the technologies, all bring in Tibet. But with this monk, we have no weapon, we have no military, only with this text. That's all. That's very funny. This is really a big joke, what they do.